So the first thing that I was talking about, how to load the data from the text file to this new table. Now my question is, like, here we are inserting the new values over there. What I need to do, here we are inserting the new values over there, and that's why we are creating a text file like this. That's why we are creating the control file like this. Now, what I need to do, I need to append into the table. Like here we are inserting. Now the next thing what we need to do, like already the data is there. In the same table, what we need to do, we need to append the values. To append the value, we need to make some changes with the control file. So how to append into the existing table? How to append into existing table? So if I need to append into the existing table, I need to make the changes with the control file. Everything is perfectly fine. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to write load data in file, the name of the file. Here we just need to use the keyword append over there. So I'm just going to write append, save. Now I'm going to open the command prompt. In this command prompt, I'm just going to write, suppose I'm going to apply the same text file over there once again. Yeah, logical record count 5. So if I'm going to apply select star from empkc, now we are having extra recording also there. Earlier 4 record was there, now this 4 extra recording also there. So this is how you can put the append over there. So for the inserting, we don't need to put the insert keyword, but for the append, you need to keyword append over there. So this is how we can do that. It's fine. How to use the append keyword? Now, the next option is what we are having. See, right now we are having a different text file, and we are having a different control file. Now, what we can do with the SQL loader, even in the control file, you can put the text file, you can put your data. Even in control file, you can put the data. So how we can do that? Suppose this is my control file. Here we need to write in file, in the place of emp.txt, I just need to put the star over there. A star means what? Our data will be there in the same file. So now this is, everything will be the same. I'm just going to put the append over there, because once again I want to append the values and all into table emplk, field terminated by comma. If I want to make it insert, just remove this. By default it will be insert. And now what I'm going to do, I'm going to put all the data over here. This was my text file. So what I'm going to do, I'm just copy this text file and all. This was my text file. I'm just going to copy this in the control file itself. Yeah, this data is there. I'm going to put the copy. Yeah, I'm just going to make some changes. Save this file, save, and run from here. The same command, SQL loader, user ID is equal to scott/tiger, control is equal to a.ctl. The good thing about it is we don't need to mention the multiple file. Even in the single control file, everything is there. I'm just going to use this. Yeah. Oh, there is the problem, like expecting keyword into or keyword begin data. So something is missing that I need to check. Field terminated by comma. Okay. I'm just going to use, like, it's saying like missing the begin data. So I need to write the keyword over here. I'm just going to apply begin data. Save this. Run this. Yeah, it's inserted. Apply the selector statement. See, all the data is there now. So this is how we can put all the data in the control file, and this is how we can use this. Now, what we can do, like the data can be in the different format. Like my data is available over here. My data can be in the different format. So how we can do this? If the format of data is changed, then what I need to do? Suppose my data is in this format, like employee number is there, employee name is there, and after the employee name, department number is going to be differentiated by dollar. Might be department number is going to be differentiated by dollar. It's not the comma. Yeah, it's a dollar. It's not the comma. So my department number is going to be separated by dollar. It's not the comma over there. It can be the different separator. It can be the different separator over there. It's not the comma. So my department number is going to be separated by dollar. My employee number and employee name is going to separate by. My employee number and employee name is going to separated by some other characters and all. So what I need to do, I need to mention everything over there. So how we can do that? In this case, I am writing field terminated by comma. By default, the comma is there, so I am just going to write field terminated by comma, employee number, comma, employee name, and then after the name, our department number is there, and that particular department number is terminated by dollar. So I am just going to write enum terminated by, I am just going to apply dollar comma. So I need to mention the terminator. So I'm just going to write employee name terminated by dollar and everything. Yeah, it's fine. Save this file and run this file. SQL loader, user ID is Scott/Tiger, control is equal to a.ctl. Yeah. Check this. Once again, we are having 16 records in there. So this is how we can deal with the different terminators. Like, see, because it's a text file, the data can be in the different format. So how we can maintain that? For that, we can just use enum. After the enum, the termination is there for the department number, and it's terminated by dollar. So I'm writing enum terminated by dollar. Yeah, up to this, the enum is there. Then we are having the department number. And suppose in department number, again, we are having the hash. So what I need to do, again I need to write terminated by hash. So I'm just going to mention department number terminated by hash. File, save this, open the command prompt, run this command once again. Yeah, check this. Yeah, it's again get inserted. So this is how we can deal with the different terminators. If we are having the different terminators over there, still we are able to copy the data from there. This is how we can do this. Now, the next thing is like, the important thing is like, if we don't have any terminator, then what we need to do? Like, we are having the employee number. We don't have the terminator over there, and our data in this particular format, like our data in this format. Yeah, our data is in this format. So how we can do this? Like, we don't have any terminator over there. So what we need to do, we need to specify the position. Something should be there. So what we can do, we can check it out through the position. So we are just writing like field terminated by comma, field terminated by comma. In fact, the comma is not there. So at the time of inserting the values, what we need to do, imply number, and in the imply number we need to put the position. Position, and the position will be from 1:4. 1:4. The same thing we put, need to put the ename and all. So ename, again I'm going to give the position. I am mentioning the position like ename is from, this is 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th, 9th. So I'm just going to give 5th:9. Again I'm going to give the department number. Department number, and again I'm going to give the position from 10 to 11. And again I need to mention by salary and position from 12 to 12 13 14 15. I'm just going to mention that. So this is how we can put the position over there. Save this file, execute this, check it out. Yeah, this data also get copied over there. So even if we don't have the terminator, we are having the option that we can put the position like this. Now what I can do, at the time of insertion, even you can change the data also. Like at the time of insertion, even you can change the data also. Like I'm going to give the ename. Ename is of type position. And suppose I'm going to give the name like this. I'm going to name a small case. I'm going to give the name in a small case. I'm going to give the name in a small case. So what I need to do, I need to put the name in the uppercase. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to write ename and position, and after the position I'm just going to mention like upper of colon in, upper of colon in. Close this. So all the data that will get stored over here will get converted into the uppercase. I run this. Check it out. Yeah. All the data get copied over there. A, B, B, C, C. It gets converted into the uppercase. So what I am trying to say, like at the time of insert, even you can make the changes over there. You can make the changes over there. So this is how we can do this. Suppose here we are inserting the values, like we are having the multiple records over there. Like multiple record is there. Like we are having the data from the department number 10, we are having the data from department number 20. Suppose I'm going to give like 999, just for your identification. I'm just giving the name and all. What I want to do, I want to display, I want to insert only those data where like department number is 10. I want to put only those values where department number is equal to 10. So what we can do, I'm writing into table emplk, and I'm just putting when department number is equal to 10. When department number is equal to 10. Copy this, save this, execute over here. Yeah, we need to check this. Department number is equal to 10. Yeah, check it out. It was 999.
So you have to use quotes as well, even though the department number is a number type?
We just need to check it out. Expecting quoted string or hex index compound 10 when the bottom is equal to 10. Just do that.
So when you inserted the previous values before, did the department number changed?
Okay, just I'm removing this. Logical record count 3, check it out. 26 20, yeah, only one record get counted. It was 9 this one. So this is how you can put the condition for. So what I am trying to say, by the use of SQL loader, it's not only load the data, even you can put the condition, even you can put some validations kind of stuff over there. So this is the good thing that we can apply for. And one important thing is, like, here we are using load data. Suppose we can also load the data from the multiple file. Even we can load the data from the multiple file, like emp.txt file is there. I am just going to change it out. 11 12 13 104, it's 11. I'm just copy the file, save. Again, I'm going to copy the notepad and going to save this. It's 21 22 23 and 24. File, save. emp1.txt. So we are having the two text file. One is emp file and one is emp1.txt file. So what I need to do, I need to change with the control file. So I'm going to open the control file and make a change. Load data, in file. In the in file, I'm going to mention the name of the file. My first file is, it's emp.txt file. So I'm just going to mention that emp.txt file. Again, my another file is there. So again, I'm going to mention the in file is equal to emp1.txt file and append. And I'm going to remove this. And I'm going to remove all this. Yeah, because my data is there in the different file. File, save, run this. Yeah, let's get copied. Check it out. 27 was there, now it's 35 is there. Yeah, all the data get copied over there. So this is the beauty of the SQL loader. This is really useful utility for you, because every time if you are going to apply the work and all, like if you are going to do something for this, every time you need to work with this. So this is what exactly